Alright, continuing from earlier, same night, part two or part one of just general talking about my life experiences, the things I'm going through, my anxieties, my fears, my shadows, my light, my ascendant self, my Merkaba, my Stargate, all Stargate. You gotta open that, you gotta tap into your enterprise. But like I was saying earlier, we're going through a lot. Look, I'm still going through this. It's not an everyday thing, but it's been for the last 3-4 days. I'm a real realist. Like, even when I'm wrongest to the deepest wrong, I accept my faults. But you know, sometimes you be so real, like you just keep making these faults. For my instance, my case, for instance, you keep making the same mistakes over and over, you know, and you wonder why. You like, I don't want to do this shit. I don't want to smoke cigarettes. I don't want to drink alcohol, but I find myself still going back to it, still drinking, still smoking, and have party on occasion. I had drug problems for a few years of my life, you know. And I'm grateful for all my experiences, but it was unnecessary. I don't want my younger brothers and sisters, or my elder brothers and sisters, or my current age brothers and sisters, because we all in the same generation, to go through the same things, like over and over and over. Like, you know, like if you don't have to go through it, that's what I'm trying to say. I just been going through a lot. A lot of people say proper right now because of COVID type of stuff going on, whatever that fraudulent shit. You know, it's real, but it's not. You know, as real as you make it. But all that's going on, so people probably feel like it's a hard time for everybody. And it is to a certain degree, but like, I'm not saying my situation is worse than everybody, but it's get realer and realer. Like, you know, like, shit is real out here. That's what I'm saying. The more conscious you are, the more aware you are, the more realization you have of the realness of life. Like, we can't be fucking around with each other. We can't be fucking over each other. We gotta, like, give self-love to each other. I mean, self-love to ourselves and love to each other. Like, I call it agape. Look up the word. It's a Greek word. It's called agape. It might be pronounced a little different in actual Greek, but I call it agape, and it's more closer to it if it's not it. It means unconditional, beyond unconditional love. It's like agape is like when you see something so beautiful, you just in awe on top of the beyond unconditional love. So that's where we need to be at. I'm like, I'm a musician, I'm an artist, I'm a big brother, I'm a son. I don't necessarily, my cousins, to me, like, we're brothers and sisters. We're very close, all of us. I would like to think so. Anyway, you know, the world's so corrupted, you just, sometimes you just don't know. You know, you're like, damn, will my mother, like, sell me out? Or, like, sell my soul, like, for her well-being type shit. You know, it's just a really corrupt society now. But that's not what it really is. That's the facade. That's the influence, the corruption. And we feed into that corruption. But what we got to get into is, like, who... Naturally, I think people are good. I really do think people are good naturally. You know, some people say white people have less emotions or less concern and care. Now, I have a lot of white friends, and I'm not a biased. I don't even like saying white friend. I just look at us as humans at least, you know. But they don't feel certain ways about certain things, you know. It takes more for them. And it might have something to do with the genetic makeover of their bodies their genetics or whatever. And same thing with the brain. If the brain is dysfunctional, it, you know, And according to Yaqub theory and so many other different philosophies and theories about, like, you know, how different races came about, like white people, the Yaqub theory is white people are the weaker gene. Like, now me, my mother, my cousins, my brothers and sisters, you know, my cousins and my brothers and sisters, we're mixed like fuck. Like, you know, we consider black, of course, like, because once you got like at least a 16 of black in you, you're pretty much black. And I got more than 16, at least 25-35%, but I look predominantly black. I, like, in America, you would consider me more black than anything. And but I don't identify with those categories. I identify with the actuality. I am we are electromagnetic beings, meaning we push, we repel and magnetize energy. That's naturally all energy. I could say fuck you, you could take it a negative way, and it could push something against you, and you could like repel against, and it cause a fight, conflict, you know, for example. But yeah, we're electromagnetic beings. Like, that'll be the actual term for it. If we was to revise and be on some new seance stuff and revise stuff and base it off what it really is, that's what we'll be. You know, you could code name it human, you could code name it black, this and that and third. But yet and still, we are electromagnetic beings. We push and pull in energy, and we conserve energy. You know what I'm saying? We're spiritual, which is energetical, light beings that collect matter. Like, you know, atoms and particles, they have matter collected around them, and they spin. And this is held together by all that shit. It's a power. It's a force. It's a reservoir in you. You know? In us. I want to be more of an inspirational person. Like I said, I'm 43 now. I was one of those people, and I still am, like, at the human part of me, it was more of one of those people that felt like, you know, I'm 20 forever. I'm not saying I want to party forever and shit like that, but, like, you know, as far as my genetics, my health, I'm gonna always be youthful and in good spirit and stuff like that. And I am to the most part, but we all go through it, just put it like that. And, you know, wear and tear and all that stuff come on top of that. No matter how healthy you could be, like, you know, in this world, like, when you just reach age 40, 43, you could be beautiful and gracefully aging. You could be really beat up. You could be beat up, but you got, you know, your beauty is so strong, you still shine. So, this for my, all my generations. When I say my generations, it's everybody that's living on this fucking planet Earth right now. Get off that shit. Like, the kids, the babies, like 20, 30s, and 19s, and 20s, kids and so forth, and babies. Like, we gotta be a better example, you know. And I'm the best to say that, because I've been the worst of an example. You know, I've been inconsiderate in my own unconscious way. You know, it's not me. I don't purposely want to be inconsiderate. I'm not purposely thinking I'm inconsiderate. But when I think back and I look at my life and I look at stuff, I consider a lot of inconsiderate things that I've done or acted like, you know. And we all selfish out here in this world. We all, like, you know, it's all about us. It's all about me. I. We need to really, like, I'm here with my family now. Like, we need to build a business together. So all us working a job and doing our own thing and trying to come up separately. Well, we're going to come up together and then build off of that enterprise and build our own development individually, all gift to the world from there, you know? I'm a very passionate person. I'm a singer, I'm an artist, like I said. I've been beat up and damaged, you know what I'm saying? So my voice, I feel like sometimes my voice ain't as best as it should be, or it can be, or it was now, but it's still there. Like, you know, I'm the type of person, I'm far away from that selfish side of life that we all go through or live in. Like, And I'm more like, you know, if I got a song or whatever, or an idea or a vision, and I see somebody else better fit for it, I would prefer them do it, because that's the vision, that's the art. I want it Picasso, like what I'm trying to say is agape, beautified, and inspirational. That's the type of music I make. Now, I ain't gonna say I'm not a rapper, and I am a rapper, but like, you know, yeah, of course I could rap some music, but like, I'm an artist. Like, it's pop, rock, rap, whatever. Like, however it come out, artistical flow. It's an inspirational thing. I draw off all this music I listen to, all the music we listen to. We inspire by it some way. And I just take it and I use it and revert it to the world from a celestial point of view in my heart and my true higher self to how I feel like it should be expressed to the world from this time point. And for, you know, because I just want to be an inspiration to you guys and myself, and I am an inspiration to myself, but it's been hard. Like, you know, like, I'm not suicidal, I don't want to die, I don't want to kill myself, but the thought has crossed my mind, just like, damn, I can't, like, if people trying to kill me or this and that and third, I don't want to be here, man. I feel like I'm in, like, hell. Like, we all go through, we all make mistakes in life. Like, I don't know, like, why people want to hurt people all the time. I just don't agree with it. I don't like it. I did it before in my life because I grew up. I'm not blaming you, Tupac, brother. You was a beautiful brother. You had a lot of beautiful music, like Brenda Had a Baby, Dear Mama, and so forth. You know, Pac was, like, against drugs, violence, all that stuff. But then he got into the world and it affected him, and people started fucking him, and demons were attacking him, and he started getting aggressive. You know, he started talking about the shit that's going on around him and what he's seeing, on top of the things he preached and he talked about as far as like development and overcoming and fuck the drugs and so forth, you know. Yeah, this is not about YouTube, TikTok, or anything like that. I've been trying to, the universe and God been trying to like express me to get on these platforms to put music, blogs, and so forth out. But, you know, it's been up and down with me. It's been difficult. I've been going through a lot of heavy anxieties since I've been out here where I'm at now for the last 9-8 months. I had like at least four, maybe five heat cups, to be realistic, you know, maybe six at the most. I don't know, like, it's just not worth it, because you gotta have willpower. My last name is Williams, so I am I use that philosophy behind Williams' last name, and, you know, even if it comes from slave master or whatever, it's an energy that's attached to me, and that my ancestors lived through that. And yours did through whatever your last name. But I'm a Williams in this world, in this country. And I look at it as like will. Like, you have the will I am. Like, you have the willpower. Like, that's, you know, my family preached that, really. Williams, we're known for being very willpower people. My cousin, Benny, man. Love that brother, man. He's been there my whole fucking life. He ain't perfect like the rest of us, but he got a beautiful family now. His wife is awesome. You know, my anxiety and my post-traumatic stress affect that sometimes. I don't trust nobody. I think everybody against me sometimes and shit. Now, definitely hope I'm wrong. It's a difficult process, but, you know, I ain't going to get into all that. But, mental health come from chemical imbalances, you know. I was on drugs from 38 to, like, pretty much 41, 42, and I'm 43 now, and I had, like, six, five heat cups, maybe four. Like, I'm just trying to be as real as possible. It could have been less, but probably six, I don't know. I don't want to talk about it. But, yeah, we got to check ourselves before we wreck ourselves. Ice Cube, back in the day. Go check out that song, y'all. I'm just filming this right now, just on my phone. I don't know what platform I might put this on or whatever. And again, it's not for quote unquote just for the fact of inspiring you. I mean, it's for inspiring you guys, but it's not for the fact of like just making a YouTube channel for entertainment or TikTok and just making you laugh and dance. That's fine. That's good. Well, I'm glad we got people like that. It helps. It's inspiring. But my thing is, like, you know, I want to, like, help us get back to actuality and get out of a reality, you know, and get to actuality, like, what it is, what shit really worked in life. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, how gravity really works, how it's really defined, for example. Like, that's the actuality. The reality, you can fly planes, you can walk around, whatever, I don't know. I'm chopped up about it. I'm not too intellectual in that area at the moment, because again, I'm just more relaxed. I'm just coming out of an extreme strong anxiety attack. It's very embarrassing. It's heartbreaking to see my family, and especially my little family, my younger family members, the kids, see me go through certain things. And to have, you know, my mother on the phone with me for a couple of hours trying to calm me. Post-traumatic stress is real. Anxiety is real. I went through it later in life, and like I said, in my 30s. I probably was going through some things like in my mid-20s and stuff like that. But I think, yeah, what I was going through then in my mid-20s is what they call it. I was incarcerated for 7 years, 9 months to be exact, maybe a few days extra for aggravated assault. It wasn't nothing. It's not me, just put it like that. I was just being a stupid kid, got scared, got caught up. Yeah, crazy shit. From Chicago, living in Atlanta. And, you know, Tupac era. I had that all out. I had the brunette of the baby. I was all rebel and positive. I'm still them, like, but not more like rebel. I'm not like anti and shit. I'm just for development and well being. You know, I want to make sure all is well. Like, you know, I'm the type of brother that I feel like all, like if they say gang members are fighting each other and why is this and that, I rather all of them be together and work shit right. Same with the government and them, the gangs with the governments and the mafia, whatever. I feel like we all need to come together, but some shit just gotta stop. And that goes for me. You know, I don't believe in taking nobody's life, you know, like over anything. Like, you know, they ain't take nobody's life or anything like that. And it's still not in our hand to do that. But, like, we need to just try to be as encouraging to each other as possible and inspiring as possible. Make beautiful whatever you do. Work into your excellence. Like, do the best job. Whatever you do, do the best at it. You know, I'm like, I was in a program at 39. No, 40. And it was one of the most beautiful times after that little super dark time I went through in New York. Like, those 4 years or whatever, I started to see beauty again. It's like a child being born and opening his eyes to a new world. I felt that way. And all my people out here that struggle with drugs, heroin, crack, meth, blues and pills that I recently, you know, my problem been lately, the reason I relapsed the 6 times or 5 times or 4 times, whatever I did, because I'm fucking, you know, chasing women and shit. And unfortunately, like, I had no intentions of doing anything, like, especially the first few women I went out here to see. And they had shit on them. And the first lady, I told her, no, I'm not with it. But, you know, getting to the intimacy and she's doing the shit, smoking. I'm like, you know what, fuck it. I took a hit. And not worth it, ladies and gentlemen. Y'all overcome, man. If you want to do better, and you want to stop something, I mean, if you want to do it, like, that's the beginning. That's the start. Like, don't beat yourself up. Like, get off. The shit could kill you, man. Quick. Like, and it could, and on top, like, even worse than death, I think, is it could destroy your family and things around you. Like, that's even more intense, you know? So, like, I don't know, man. Like, I'm still dealing with anxiety a little bit, trying not to feel like people are trying to take my life. And, I mean, I know it's somewhat true to a degree, because I know it's demonic forces out here. I know it's, you know, I don't like to say government, but, like, you know, demonic forces controlling all areas of different categories of life. And I'm not saying demons, like, just they gotta be demon, but just demonic, the energy, you know. And they could be demons too, shit real. Like I said, this shit ain't all it is what you see. We in a prism. We in a light prism. Meaning we only see 1% of matter. 99% of matter is energy, which we don't see. Other than we feel the sun, but we only see 1%. Something like that. So I think I'm no, I don't want to end now necessarily. I just want to let it roll through. I hope I got enough attention where a lot of people carry on this far to listen to what another part of you. I'm another part of you. Like, we're all a extension of each other, like, in some way. So, you know, that's how I like the Bible said, love your neighbor like you love yourself, or some of that nature. Like, you know, love your neighbor pretty much. Like, you love your family and stuff. And it used to be like that. I got glimpses of that in my younger childhood, like, where families was like, you could be the next door neighbor, the cousin, the brother, the auntie, the friend. Like, you getting treated like family, and you're going to be checked in a positive way. You know, sometimes you can whoop your ass, stitch a cord, not stitch a cord, but like switches and belt. And, you know, that's how they knew how to deal with stuff, because they come from a slave mentality. I want to make a note on that since we're talking about it. Don't whoop your kids like that. Whoop them when they're young. If you have to, spank them. I'm not saying beat the hell out of them, but spank them, like, when they're young. Like, if you have to. But, like, think more of more lucrative ways of dealing with the problems to get them in check. You know what I'm saying? Because if you're doing that, you're going to teach them to respond and to handle everything in violence, you know? And violence, as we see, like, nobody wants violence to happen to them, so it's not good. Like, you want love to happen to you, so that's not bad. So, you know, you get what I'm saying? So, yeah, you gotta stop the violence, you gotta stop the drugs, you gotta stop the biasness, so-called racism. I got, like, my last girlfriend was a hippie redneck chick, and her whole family was rednecks. And she warned me going over there. She was like, look, if you want to leave, just let me know we could go, because they're going to be saying stupid shit. They rednecks. They this, that. She didn't necessarily consider them racist. They just got a point of view. Well, she's sort of right, but it's still racist. You know what I'm saying? That's just bullshit. And I let them rock. A lot of my brothers I talked to about it, they're like, man, hell no, I wouldn't let that shit. I wouldn't let them say that and that. But, you know, I was being an observer, and I was respecting my girlfriend at the time and trying to be honorable for her, you know. And again, I'm for black people, because we have been through a lot of shit as a generation and stuff like that, you know what I'm saying? But I represent life, period. You know what I'm saying? White people been through shit. Some white peoples, Asian people, Arab people, we all been through some type of shit. But black people in America, they gave us hell. They fucked us up. And it's in our blood. And it's a anger in there. And we got to use that anger in a progressive, evolutional, positive way. And when I say positive, I'm talking about energetically, like adding on and building. You know, and like, just let go all the excess, you know, take the good from the bad. to smoke one more cigarette. I gotta work all day tomorrow. I took 2 days off because this anxiety and me fucking off with some chick. And like, I'm really, now that I've been sober and shit, I'm thinking about like, what the fuck did I deal with? I disgust myself every time, I ain't gonna lie to you. It's not that they necessarily ugly or anything like that, it's just like, what the fuck am I thinking? Just, and that's been my problem. Some people, some of us, we hurt ourselves. We might not be suicidal, we might not be cutters on our arm, but me, I've noticed, I tend to hurt myself. I think a lot of us do it unconsciously, and I have been for years. But I hurt myself when I'm hurting. You know? When I'm happy, oh my God, the world is lit up. The meanest motherfucker can't do but smile around me at some point. You know? Like, and I have been there more than a few times. It's a, that's the most key, magnificent light points of times in my life. You know? When I first got out here, I was glowing. I was super happy. I was fucking up this time, though. I was still drinking. I was smoking. I was super too happy. So I didn't know how to handle that energy. So I'm smoking and drinking and sitting in my car and, like, trying to make YouTube videos. I can't get into it because I'm fucking just too ecstatic, you know. The time before that, I was happy. Me and my ex-wife was, we moved from Atlanta to Chicago. And that's a beautiful, Veronica, you're a beautiful woman. I apologize for my immaturities and all the ways I was. You deserve great. I'm happy for you. I hope you definitely happy. And like I told you last time I talked to you, it's not trying to get back with you. You left me 9 years ago, 8 years ago or something, 7 years, somewhere around there. But I lost my mind, baby. Wait, I still call you baby. I lost my mind, Veronica. Pardon me. I lost my mind, Veronica, during those years. Be happy. I think everything we go through is worth it, you know, because if it wasn't, you know, we wouldn't probably become the greater person we are. Everybody don't make it. Like, I see people that's been, for example, on drugs, crack, or whatever for 20, 30 years. Like, my biological father is probably 60-something years old. Beautiful man. And his beautiful spirit and heart. I see where I get that from. My mom the same way, though. So I'm, like, super fucking, you know, sweetheart. But my dad, he got a little raging shriek in him, so I got a little of that too. But I'm humble more nowadays more than ever. He don't want to stop. That's his life, man. Like, you know, he's matured about it. I'm not condoning it, saying it's okay, but, you know, like, I love him. This person that my mother said he raped her, and that was hard for me to deal with as a child. But you know, he really didn't rape her, but my mom took it as that way because, you know, like, after, you know, I don't want to get into all the detail, but after they was all the way involved into the interaction of that, she wanted him to stop. So years later, Oprah Winfrey came with this "Know Me No." So my mom was like, "Oh shit, I was raped then." But I don't know, something like that. I love my mom. She's like, you know, she ain't like she lying or trying to, you know, she ain't like fuck my dad up or anything like that. Like I said, he was a beautiful guy, man. He's just, I don't know why he on that shit, man, and why he fucked up. But he don't want to stop, and he just, that's what his life is. I mean, this man, probably reason I fell into it eventually, because he probably did it before I was conceived. I don't know. It was like 20, 21 when he had me. My mom was 16. But, He's been on that shit at least since, if it wasn't then, at least since it was in his late 20s, early 30s. I'm assuming. I don't know for sure. Drake, you know, Drake dad remind me of my dad. They kind of got that same type of energy. I trip about that a lot. Like, and shout outs to Drake, man. Y'all, Lil Wayne, Drake, man, so many others. Like, and I'm not like riding a wave or anything like that. It's just like I've been really checking them out. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm godson over here, and you know, even though I go through my own human shit like everybody else, I'm still like thinking godly and concerned and care for everything. I'm listening and observing. And Drake them, you know, like, you know, they got their dark music or whatever, but they really, man, that's where they at. That's where it's at. Like Drake, Lil Wayne, you know, they don't, like Bruce Lee said, don't, like, if I'm pointing at the moon and I'm telling you about the importance of what I'm pointing to, which could be a moon or whatever the case may be. Don't focus on my fucking finger. Don't focus on the person and what they're going through or whatever. Listen to the reality. Listen to the actual. Listen to the truth. Like the, you know, I don't know how to say it right now. I'm like really chopped up about it. But just don't focus on the finger. Focus on the man. Look at the objective. Look at the goal. Like, look at the message. That's what I'm trying to say. Yeah. So, what else? Did I smoke my cigarette? No, I'm like, you see this shit? I'm talking like I gotta smoke a cigarette because I'm drinking. Like, it's just, what is going on with us? This is a habit. It could be a burger. I'd be a fat kid. Like, man, I gotta have a burger now. I just took a shit. I gotta get a burger. It sounds crazy, but people be like that. Shit. You know, we all got these fucking habits, and I'm not judging to judge anybody like that. I'm like identifying to like ask for help myself because I'm struggling, and then at the same time offer inspiration and try to inspire help and give help to somebody else might need more help than me. You know, so how long is this video? 32 minutes. All right, we're gonna smoke a cigarette. Unfortunately, if I can find them, and then we're gonna continue for a little bit more. See if anything pop off the that I can say to you guys. I'm trying to get more into this, man. I hate that I have to go through such extremities and get so extra passionate already. Like, I'm already super passionate, but I sometimes so passionate I be singing and making music and shit. People be looking at me like, I'm like, yeah, it is rough, man. Damn. But, you know, but I don't know. It's a beautiful thing, man. I love them, and I love the music. And y'all, we got to do this. I'm team Israel right now, and that's not saying I'm selfish. That's saying that, you know, I'm for my well-being, and my well-being is consistent with other people's well-being. You know what I'm saying? So I couldn't be a $800 billion guy and like see even a city like just struggling and shit. I would be getting all types of opportunities. I like, you gotta come with something. Like, you can't be doing what I'm doing now, drinking and smoking. Just, I mean, if you're making YouTube videos and you're close enough, yeah. But that was selfish too. But you know, like, if you like, I know you're gonna do it. You know what I'm saying? I still invest in you. I still throw money out there for people because it's that's what money is. Money is a machine. It's meant to be spent and invested and recycled. And you get it back and you build and you make more and more. You buy this, that, and the third. It's a machine. Cash machine. Cash cow. Make your cash cow. Make your cash goat. Whatever the fuck you want to call it. You got to make beautiful music. Kanye West also. Like, that's another brother. Like, man. I don't give a fuck what they say about my G. That's my brother. I love him. Kanye West, shout out, bro. Like, I love everybody in the world, to be honest. Like, you know, everybody. Like, I don't give a fuck how bad you been. Like, you know, like, for example, Jeffrey Dahmer, you probably think a person like that is unlovable. They fucked him up, killed him, everything. That dude was sick, man. You know, but I love him, but I don't like that shit that he was about and shit like that. But, I don't know. That's deep. I went too deep. Jeffrey Dahmer and shit. But it's people fucked up out here. Don't get me wrong. It's really fucked up demonic people. So, like, them forces get to people. I don't think Jeffrey Dahmer was a drinker, smoker, and none of that shit. So it was just his brain. That's how he was. Something demonic possessed that man to eat and kill people and get gay guys or whatever the fuck it is. They're doing all types of sick shit, bro. And ladies. Like, I ain't mean to get all on that, but I'm just trying to express how, like, I love the world and we should all love the world. And, it's people want to purge and get rid of people like Jeffrey Dahmer, which you don't want nobody like that around. You know what I'm saying? But that's people that's like that. But you got people that's trying to change and people that want to do it. They just the mere fact that you thinking or you speaking that you want to be better, it's in your heart, you know, and you can maybe have to work through a lot of shit that you develop unnecessarily to get to that point, you know. And I'm a late boomer. Like, I spent all my young years in college, most of my beginning early years incarcerated, unfortunately. And I'm trying to stop talking about my past. I don't want to really get into my past as much because I don't want people passing judgment and stereotyping, per se. That's what I'm really trying to say, stereotyping and whatnot. That's another reason I don't like to give my age either, because if I tell a person I'm 20 and they, oh, you don't know shit. Hey, kid, I could tell you this, that, and third, for example. If you're 40, oh, man, you're too old. You know, and I can't, like, I'm finna go do this with my homies. Like, I'm like, bro, like, I'm very well-versed in, like, life, you know. I love all my people, you know. Like, my baby cousins, look, I consider them more nieces and nephews to me, because, man, Danny is definitely, like, my brother. And, you know, like I said, none of us perfect, man. And anything he might have done wrong to me, or did do wrong to me, or will do wrong to me, I forgive him. Because, like, I know in his heart, like, that's my bro. No matter what. So, I forgive my enemies. If my anxiety that I feel is true, I forgive them. They just doing what they feel in their mind probably be right. So I don't know why or what, but either way it be, what I'm right or wrong about it, I want us, as be my soul to be everlasting, your soul to be everlasting. If it cross over to the astral plane, because I'm pulling you back here, it'll be here. But then, like, you go on and you come back, or you could fucking be so evil like Jeffrey Dahmer, per se. And I wish you brother get enough life experience he could develop something better and more beautified. And so I don't know what the hell's happened with him. But he's a perfect example of some demonic shit. And, some people like that, their soul catch on fire, like ether. Ether don't stop burning. It burns forever. Like, your soul will burn forever. It's turmoil and torture. So, like, your soul doing that, you might, I'm just speculating, I'm just, you know, just kind of reaching into my Akasha records a little bit, that, you know, your soul to be burning, but your mental aspect could be trapped in the astral plane. You run around with shadow beings or worse, like in Silent Hill type shit. So, but them motherfuckers have crossed over now. They ain't learned how to get in, live in this world too, and be in the astral plane. So, watch out. Get out here. But I'm not saying that to be create any fear mongering or anything like that. But fear is courage. That's one thing they did teach me. Like, you know, even like people in the astral plane or what you consider demonic or shadow beings and all that. I'm not saying they just necessarily good or evil, you know, they probably, because from my point of view, they probably have a very demonic perspective, but some of these souls probably pissed, you know, they want to see the world better, and they're like, y'all fucking all, we trying to do this because we know this coming, or we got to do that, and then and third, and like, they get very demonic, shit. So some of them like that, but then some of them just really fucking demonic, they don't give a fuck, they just want to hurt you. Because they can and get it, they ain't got no consequences because they're in the astral plane. I mean, to some degree, they're gonna keep them trapped there for one. Boy, they do got consequences, it's gonna keep them trapped there, and they're just gonna get they've sold probably eventually catch on fire to keep that shit up. But they don't know that because they ain't in time and space like us, even if they cross over. So they just fucking they sold. In that dark state of mind, they aggressive like that. And you can't tell them no different. Not by talking to them. Hell no. They ain't trying to hear that shit. They might listen, man. They ain't trying to hear it. This shit real out here, y'all. Okay? It's your big brother. Your elder brother. Your brother. And father to some of you, a lot of you, and I want to see us do greater things and better things in this world. I'm not the president of the United States, but I have a voice just like the president of the United States, and you do too. So let's do this, y'all. I worked hard in my little, you know, some people might say, oh, working hard is like having a job all day, working triple shifts and shit like that for 10, 15 years. No, I'm talking about life, period. Life is a business. Like, we all been working hard somewhere. Some of us just be fucking off, and I have fucked off too, but it's work. I make it work still. So I never stop working, never. So even when I'm fucking off, it's kind of like work because I'm like, in my own sick little demeanor mind, I'm investigating some shit. You know? I'm trying to see what's up. So again, I'm gonna end this video part 2. Thank y'all. Peace.